are at 5th District Mini Farm, 2208 Bainbridge Street. And 5th District Mini Farm was started about 3 years ago. The work is to kind of get community involved, to make sure that everyone is kind of learning that you can kind of grow your own food. Make it go from the farm to your house. It's healthier, it's better. Just trying to get the community involved too. So we have different groups come out to kind of learn and cultivate things that we are doing. Trying to just kind of bring it together, make it all cohesive so that everyone knows that this isn't like strange. Like urban gardening isn't strange. It's very necessary. It's very important for the community. It's important for our health. And so that's why it is here. That's why we continue to grow and continue to kind of put the word out there so that people know that this is something that's very necessary.
The garden is here to inspire. You know, it's a place where people can come and do their thing and just leave the stress of everyday work or whatever and just come, like I said before, do something different. All this was like flat land, but it was the hill. So we had to just take the tillers and just till everything up, everything up. It took like maybe a month. You know what I'm saying? It's just dedication, man, getting out here. We was out here like every Saturday and Sunday, sun up, sun down, you know, just tilling. And I had a design already in my head about how to do it, you know what I'm saying, the layout. So I just laid the sketch after the tilling. I had to find a way to stop the pooling down at the bottom of the hill. So I was like, we're going to do raised burn beds. And that's like these mounds here. They actually stop the water, and by stopping the water, they absorb it. So by them absorbing it, the root system of the plant is always getting water. And so it helps me not to come out here every day and water.
They needed an irrigation system, more so than just a rain catchment, because that's pretty simple to catch water. But to automate and then as well as irrigate the farms, because again, we got a small crew. We don't have people here every day.
Now with that, this is the rain catchment system, so it's gonna feed a drip irrigation to each row. But the drip irrigation is not gonna be on top like most. It's gonna be inside of the bed. So it's just pushing all the water straight to the root system. And a big reason why I figured to go in the rows inside of it was because in the summertime, you deal with evaporation. So you have to either water early in the morning or at dusk at night. So if you have a system where the water is just straight going into the mounds, into the root system, you don't have to worry about the evaporation so much.
Because it's like a hill, it'll allow the water to drain down and it won't make it just sit there. And our crops will marinate kind of in the water as opposed to just getting wet and then the sun gets on it and it dries it out.
So what we did was when we sat down and looked at it, I got a bird's eye view from Google, and that allowed us to, you know, say where we want to send the water, where we want to place it, because this is one of the highest points on the farm, so that we can use that gravity. What we also did here, because of the small footprint that I had, I extended the roof so that I can get multiple gutter systems up there. So in essence, on one roof in the same footprint, I've got four areas to capture water. When this is full, then that will send it over there as well for the substation. So that backs up this right here. So it's never a loss or a waste at all.
And one of my things I tell young people, man, always follow your dreams. Dreams plus action equals results, man. Because this was all just a dream at one point. Like, this was just a thought. And I put the action behind it, and this is what it equals. You know what I'm saying? A space where people can come learn, and people can get inspired. Like, one of the things we have is we have a lot of volunteer days out here. You know what I'm saying? Some people for the first time, you know what I'm saying, coming out here to volunteer, and they have a great experience. And they end up leaving with plants. Like, hey, we ready to go start our own thing. We ready to go start composting, you know what I'm saying? So that's part of my fulfillment with that. Like, okay, I done touched somebody. I don't care if it's one person. You know, you get one, you can get another one.
It's a learning process. Like, you're always learning. Urban gardening is something that is ever evolving. So it's nothing, you don't do the same things every day. We can weed today, we can do something different tomorrow. So it's really good to get the community involved, to get just random people that walk by or that come by and see that there's a garden out here. They're like, how can I be involved in that? What can I do? Are we just picking stuff? What are we doing? Like, people ask questions, and that's what we need, because the more questions that people ask, the more people are telling other people, their neighbors, their friends, their family members about community gardens all over, and that's what keeps that interest up. That's what gets people to come out and participate and see the growth from weeding to tilling to actually harvesting and providing crops or free things to people, produce to people, people buy stuff. Like, that's what it's all about, just actually seeing the from beginning to end.